What is good, my peeps? It is your Knuckle Big Rucker back at you again with another action figure review. This is number two in our line of Hasbro Marvel Legends Disney Plus, the number four wave in this line of figures. And what we have here is, I said number two in our reviews, but it's actually number one in the building of Khonshu, which is this wave's BAF, its Build-A-Figure. We have Agent Jimmy Woo, and this is from the WandaVision TV series on Disney Plus. And I mean, we've got Jimmy Woo. I will say this, WandaVision was the very first Disney Plus show representing the MCU, and it's gotten the least amount of figures. Overall, this is only the third figure, and it's Jimmy Woo. I mean, I'll take it, but I would have preferred maybe Agatha Harkness, but I know they'll probably come out with Agatha Harkness, you know, when she has her show. But having said that, and, you know, in a way, that's kind of to our benefit, because Hasbro has no compunction about double dipping us, you know what I'm saying? So we would have gotten an Agatha Harkness for WandaVision, and then Hasbro would have given us an Agatha Harkness for her own show that's upcoming. So it's probably for the best, but we could have also gotten Monica Rambeau as well, but you know, it is what it is. We got Jimmy Woo, and it's another character. That's the pro. The con is that it's on the dreaded suited buck, especially the lower half there. You know, it's a modified suited buck. But the part that hasn't been modified, that needs the most modification, is the lower half, the legs. You can already see I've got Jimmy kind of linked over in order to get him to stand, because he just won't stand. I know there are some people that will modify the front of the shoes, so that way you could get a little bit more, you know, of it bending forward, so you could get a suited figure to stand up. I'm too much of a fraidy cat to do it on my own, so it is what it is. He's going to have to lean forward like it is. Anyhow, we've got the packaging there. You know, we're rocking the plastic-free packaging. You see the digital render of Jimmy Woo on the front, with some work at the in the back there, artwork, we'll call it. And as I stated, this is the Khonshu Build-A-Figure wave. And there's Khonshu, and we've got the six figures listed in a row of what it'll take to build Khonshu. Agent Jimmy Woo is kicking us off. On the other side, we have more of that artwork of Agent Woo right there. The top, we've got the spot varnished logo for WandaVision. You see the Scarlet Witch there. And then, of course, on the back, we have another digital render of Jimmy. And to our left, Jimmy's right, you see a sketch of the Build-A-Figure pieces that come with Agent Jimmy Woo that'll take to build Khonshu. He's got the left arm of Khonshu, as well as Khonshu's staff there. Moon Crescent staff. And then, of course, on our right, Jimmy's left, his lone accessory is another hand that's holding his card, his business card. So that's all we get. That is all we get. So it is what it is. So without further ado, let's get Jimmy on that rotating plate. And after several attempts of getting him to stand, and there's no guarantee he's going to stand now, yeah, we've got Jimmy Woo on our rotating platter going 360, and hopefully he'll stay there. If he falls, he falls. I'm not going to change it out, because if anything, it helps to illustrate what I'm talking about, the difficulty of the suited body. Anyhow, I did manage to get him to straighten up a little bit more, as I had to modify his standing pose so that he wouldn't fall while rotating. And so at first glance, of course, we already took that first glance in terms of the suited body, given the issues. But we've got the head sculpt, which is dubious at best in terms of looking like looking like our boy Jimmy. And yeah, we'll take a closer look at that to see if there are any angles that kind of look like him. He's got the G, I'm about to say G.I. Joe. Wow. He's got the FBI badge around his neck, and it is removable, so that's cool. If you want to use this buck for another character, you can do so as best as you can to try to match up the skin tones. And yeah, but anyway, let's get him off the platter and take a closer look. But before we do that, I need you guys to go below and like the video and share if you can. And while you're down there, subscribe to the channel. Help support us and get it going on. So while you guys are doing that, I will give you a close-up of Jimmy's one lone accessory and what Khonsu's working with. As I stated previously, Agent Jimmy Woo comes with the left arm to build Khonsu, and we'll set this aside as we gather the parts up so we can, at the end, if we go through everyone, we'll take care of Khonsu. Agent Wu also comes with Khonsu's spear, not or I should say staff. It's not really a spear. That Crescent Moon staff that he was carrying, it came in two pieces. You see right here, and paint detail is pretty nice on it. It's got like a brassy, platinum kind of, dirtyish tones too. So it's two-tone there. It's painted like a brass color or a not necessarily gold, but then there's a wash over to give it a dirty look. And you've got the staff portion right there, just molded in a brownish a bronze. That's the better color. Yeah, that's what this is more like a bronze color. So yeah, and as far as putting it together, you got the peg, and there you go. So we've already got that part. Getting ahead of ourselves? Nah, that's just doing the staff. That's all good. And of course, Agent Jimmy Woo's lone accessory is a left hand that has his business card, his FBI business card. And you see there's printing on there. So that's a nice touch, but it's just a shame that that's all we get. Now we've got Agent Jimmy Woo in the static pose. And I don't know how long he's going to stay static. I feel like he's teetering on the brink as we speak on him right now. But in terms of looking at his head sculpt to see how much he looks like the actor, let's take this closer look. And here we have, looking right at him, we've got Agent Jimmy Woo. I believe his real name is escaping me. Is it Randy Park? I think that's what it is. Anyhow, correct me down below if I got that twisted. Anyhow, the head sculpt could be better in terms of his likeness. The photo reel didn't really do the job this go around. Quite frankly, there are some actors, actresses, where the photo reel just doesn't take. Look at Chris Evans. Look how many tries Hasbro did in order to get his likeness accurate. They got better with every succeeding try, with every succeeding attempt, but they never really locked it down. When they got to the last one, his Infinity Saga, the last figure we got from him in the Infinity Saga line, representing him from Infinity War, they got the closest they could get to that, and even that wasn't perfect, but it was definitely the best that they've done. Now here we got here with our guy Agent Woo. You could definitely tell that he's Korean. You got that, and I believe he's Korean. He's Asian for sure. They did get that part right, and I think maybe on certain angles he'll look like it. See, yeah, like right there, I can see him. I can see him right there. And then on the other side there, his right side, not so much. Definitely though, his left side, like right there, that angle, I can definitely see him. So yeah, so they've done better. Anyhow, other than that, I mean, it's still a decent, It's a decent head sculpt. It's passable for a human being, that's for sure. You got the hair. It's just in black, no wash or anything like that. As I stated, his badge is removable, so that's cool. It's a regular suited body. He's coming there with jacket overlay. As you can see, he's got the tie, black tie. The arms are, of course, molded in green to match the jacket. So if we wanted to sport him with just the white shirt, that's not going to go because he's going to have the green sleeves. So that's unfortunate, but that's usually how it goes. Which could have been something that Hasbro could have added. We could have gotten detachable arms that could be replaced with white sleeved arms, but no, we didn't get that. He's got the hand there, and I seem to have a little error in my paint there, right there at the joint for the interior of the elbow, which is, it happens. As far as the overlay jacket, we do get paint there, so you got silver for the zippers and for the buttons going down, and then of course the vertical zipper, you got that both sides. You see that on the interior there, so that's pretty cool. This is an MCU figure, so for the most part you're always going to get pinless joints. So there we have double jointed pinless elbows. And as far as the range on it, I know I said I was going to cut down on doing articulation, but you guys at least need to be able to see how much range you can get where they bend at. Of course, he's got he's talking about he's got ab crunch and waist swivel, and of course down to the legs he's got pinless knees. Oh, excuse me. I'm sorry, that's the old buck. So he's got pinned knees. Forgive me, because this is the old thing. I've already was riffing about complaining, so how would I forget that the knees would be pinned? And then, of course, the notorious shoes. Looking at the side there, you see how they're formed there, and I got him standing straight up, and you see that even having him straight up there, look where the heel is. It wants to lean back like that if it was flat. So that's where all of our issues in terms of getting these suited bodies to stand up. Here's Agent Wu with his card carrying hand. So once again, it's the only accessory we get, so you may as well utilize it and pose him with that. And for some comparisons, we have Agent Jimmy Wu alongside the only other two figures we've gotten from the WandaVision television show. We've got Wanda and we've got Vision. More specifically, we've got Wanda as the Scarlet Witch and we've got the White Vision. And here we have Agent Jimmy Woo next to the only other figure that we have reviewed from this wave. We have Zombie Iron Man. So to sum it all up, the Hasbro Marvel Legends Conchu Wave, the Disney Plus WandaVision Agent Jimmy Woo figure is, it's another figure. The third in the WandaVision show, and that in that series of figures, we've only gotten two previous, Scarlet Witch and White Vision. Leaves a lot to be desired as far as I'm concerned. The head sculpt is dubious at best. There's only like one angle that I could actually see the actor in. We've got to deal with the lower half, which is the old style suited body. Those shoes especially, difficult to stand. And as far as the pros, we did get, as far as the upper torso is concerned, we got the new pinless double jointed arms, which is cool. If you want to use the whole buck for another figure, you could do that. The badge, the FBI badge, is removable, so you don't have to worry about that always being in the way. Other than that, there's nothing really else to say about this figure. I can tell you right now, without going through anything else, this is going to come in dead last when I scale off from 1 to 8 or 7, depending, including Khonshu, where Wu was going to rank. I can tell you that right now. So there's nothing more I can say. So If you ain't got nothing good to say, don't say anything at all. So what I will say is, please remember to like, share, subscribe to the channel, help keep us rolling, and comment below any of your questions, your concerns, your critiques. Hit me with them. And of course, while you're down there, hit that notification bell if you want to be notified for the next time I upload a video. On behalf of Agent Jimmy Wu, I am the Rock Ness Monster, leaving you with this. Remember, the hunt continues, and I'm out. Peace.